Processing. I spoke about the word processing. So when you have collected all of this, so 4000 message unit, let's take it as a standard. That is where you are calm and quiet. So I am speaking with you at a particular pace. I am speaking with 4000 message units coming per minute in my head, in my mind, and I am able to talk in this pace, in this tone. When I'm not able to talk like this and when I'm very fast, there's so many things coming in my mind that I have to say everything. I mean, I don't know how much I have to talk to you. I have gone beyond 10,000 message units per minute. Right? So the hypersensitivity is what we are talking about, which energetically it's fine. But that can create a lot of anxiety and panic also. Because if good thoughts are coming in your mind at that speed, you can't control the thoughts coming in your mind if you are not aware of it. So negative thoughts can also come at that speed. So they can also come beyond 10,000 message units per minute in your mind, creating all that negativity, and that creates the anxiety, which later on the consistency of anxiety creates panic attacks. And that is where we say, oh my God, I've become completely numb. Oh my God, I don't know what to do. Oh my God, I don't know. I am stuck. So you are there. You know that you want to cross the road, but you are standing there frozen. You don't know what to do because there's so many things coming in your mind. The simple thing is your conscious mind is not able to process that. You just have to cross. But your subconscious mind and conscious mind have something which is called as a critical filter, which has not processed what you actually want to do. And when the processing is not done, why is it not done? Because there is a program which is running inside you. The socio-economic, educational and religional, which is the developmental stages that I'm talking about, which is a completely different session which I'll be conducting. But for now, it is from 0 to 8, what are your experiences? What have you gone through? What are your upbringings, the sanskaras, the belief systems, the value systems, what have you seen, what have you heard, what have you experienced, how have people treated you, how have you seen your parents treat each other, how have you seen your parents treating their parents, how have you seen your parents or your father treating people from his office, how have you seen your mother treating her relatives or your family members. All of that is your data from 0 to 8. That's the reason 0 to 8 age is very, very vital. So anytime, whenever therapeutic work needs to be done, the 0 to 8 has to be understood, because that is very, very important, and that is where all your data has already been received and your personality has been formed till 8. And after 8, you start from 8 to, let's say, 12 or 14, you start applying it. You see, whatever you have learned, you start doing it in your near and dear ones. And then you get those experiences. And then you say, oh my God, I got this experience, but my father was doing that. Oh, my father was speaking very sweetly in front of, his boss. But back home, he was telling my mother that, oh no, no, usko na maine bahut, usko thoda sa maska lagaya hai, and he will do that work for me. And then later on, my father finds out, oh my God, that has not happened. What did I learn? That what my father was doing was not the right thing. But then I don't know what to do. So my upbringing is telling me, follow what your authority person has done and do it. And see in your own experience what is happening. So the unlearning is not happening. Unless you are aware of it. Unless you know how your mind works. That you can tweak it, you can question. You can be curious to know why and how that can be changed. for us to have a very positive approach, a positive result out of it, out of that interaction. A very simple example, but it happens in every house. So the SEER program is embedded in the critical mind filter, in the critical filter. So part of it is the conscious mind filter and part of it is the from the subconscious. Now there are associations which we do with these symbols. We see that there are lots of associations which we do, and the critical mind filter, the subconscious, it receives all of it. It just takes it in. And what happens of all of this? So when all this data is entered into the subconscious, it remains in the conscious mind for 1.5 hours. So now, when I say 1.5 hours, reflect back to the time, our school lectures, college lectures, you know, your attention span is that much, 1.5 hours, is the capacity of the conscious mind to keep the data inside. What happens after that? It goes into the critical filter. Critical filter remains 24 hours. So go back again to the school days, tomorrow's paper. You have a paper, let's say you have a paper of history. Mug up all the dates. Oh my God. Battle of Panipat. Oh my God. Whatever you are. Take up all the data. Mug it up. It remains with you for 24 hours. So you have done your studies. Let's say today in the evening. From 7 o'clock to let's say 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, whatever. Tomorrow morning you have the paper at 11 o'clock. You write down whatever you have mugged up. Till tomorrow evening, 7 o'clock, that data is there. The third day, anybody ask you the dates of any of the battles, any of the anything from the history paper, you don't remember. Because that was there only for 24 hours. Right? Now, what happens after that? So, after 24 hours, this goes into the subconscious mind. So, later on, maybe after a month, after the exams are over, tension nahi hai. Later on, somebody asks you a question, you have remembered, it doesn't go away, right? It does not go away, it is there in your subconscious. But there is a condition. You remember it if it is pleasurable. You don't remember it if it is painful. So, from there, the data goes here. There is relevant. If the data is relevant, after 24 hours, it is subdivided into whether it is a pleasurable one experience or it is a pain. It's a painful experience. And then later on, relevant, and the second part is irrelevant. The irrelevant data is thrown out. It's not required. Every morning, somebody comes in and takes away the kachra from your house, right? Garbage bin de dete hain. The wet and the dry. Pura ka pura de dene ka. The irrelevant one goes out through the dreams. Right? So we'll talk about dreams also. So here we are. So let's say the dreams. So there are three different types of dreams. The first one is the processing dream. The second one is the predictive dream. And the third one is the venting dream. So let's say ideally at 10 o'clock you sleep. So there are one third, one third, one third. Okay? So 10 o'clock you sleep, 10 to 1 becomes the processing dream. Why the processing dream? Because whatever has happened during the day, that is the time when you process what has happened. You have to decide on something. So tomorrow is a decision day. Oh my God, I have to give my boss some decision. Or somebody has, you know, proposed to me. I have to, you know, tell my boyfriend whether I'm accepting or I'm rejecting the proposal. That is a predictive one. So that part from 1 to 4 in the night. That is the time when that part is getting processed. And from 4 till 7 in the morning. The morning dreams are the venting dreams. Because processing ho gaya, predictive dreams ho gaya hai. Whatever is remaining is being thrown out. That becomes the venting dream. So we'll come about dreams again in a different setup. Because that is a completely different subject. We'll talk about a dream therapy. So here we are. So dreams, and now coming back to our super diagram. Okay. So what happens here now? The visual goes directly. there is no processing for a visual. Now connect with all the movies that you have seen. Surely, you remember the coin, you remember the last scene on the bridge, and you remember what happens. And then Jay is lying in Veeru's hands. He's passed away, he's died. And what does Veeru see? That the coin is there, and then he just curiously, just out of that moment, that intuitiveness, he just flips it and sees the other side, and both sides are the same. And then he knows the entire time what he has been doing. So Jay has been doing what he wanted to do and only flipping coin and always saying heads. A very simple example, but that is where the memory takes you. A visual. I remember it, I think most of you, majority of you, I think 90% people remember surely. And this scene particularly, that was very heart-wrenching. Heart-wrenching, touching, painful. That was what we did when we are talking about pleasure and pain. We also remember the pleasurable one. But the pain is what, you know, pain loves us. So it sticks to you. Because we let it stick to us. So, visual and then rules and experiences. Now, this is a very important concept. So, in your conscious mind, you have rules. Because it actually has a way of thinking, logic, analyzing, you know, deciding. So, right or wrong, white or black, it doesn't have anything gray. So, typical logical minds are where the rules are set. Yeah? Subconscious mind has experiences. So, whatever happened, all that experience, good, bad, scary, everything, all the emotions put into place, with all the emotions, with all the jing bang, the experience is there in your subconscious, come what may. Now, what happens? Now, this is particularly what can we use in the addiction therapies, the addiction therapies basically. So, let's say a person goes through, you know, cigarette smoking, drinking. So, the glass, when the glass is held for the first time, let's say I have a glass, so I will show you. So, the first time the glass is held, the rule says, check whether after drinking the glass, whether I was feeling pleasure or pain. Then I will say, oh, last time I had a drink, oh my god, yes, it was wonderful. I had my girlfriend with me and it was beautiful. So I'm going to drink it now. But now the girlfriend is not there with you. But the experience that you carry is a wonderful one when you are holding the drink. Right? Now, when this person gets into addiction of drinks, the first time pleasurable one needs to be substituted with pain. So I know it sounds cruel, but unless and until it is painful, unless and until this person understands that because of that drink, that girl has left you, is the pain. Right? So what you do is, so last in, first out. So computer people, last in, first out kind of a situation, what goes in last comes out first. So that emotion, the last time it happened, that was pleasurable, no, we substituted with the painful one. So this goes into therapy work. So that is pain. So when the conscious mind is checking with the subconscious, after all of this, after the therapy work and this and that, then when the glass, when the client, I can say client or the person, is trying to hold, he will not hold, he will say, oh my god, no, because of this glass, she left me. Yeah? So, my hands are not going to hold the glass. Because my logical mind is telling me, no, it was a painful experience. Don't do it. Because it will keep checking with the subconscious. And we have superimposed it, and the last in, first out has been the pain. So, I'll say, no, I don't want it. She left me last time. I don't want this. Because of this, she left me. So, whatever. I'm just creating a story so that it, you know, it's easier to understand. So, So that is where the power of experience along with the pleasure and the pain. So this is where we understand how our mind actually is working and how the rules and the experiences take part in our life. And with all of this, so like I said, the children, association and identification, they know 15,000 words without the education. Without the education, they have the capacity to know these many words. So it's crazy how the human mind is and the human brain works. We continue this as adults, the association part. Now, all of this association, so we connect with, even if he's a child, we say, haan haan, ye bacha, mera bacha doctor banega. Three Idiots story, yeah, again an association. Taj Mahal, right, then books, so this is like a scholarly person. This is trekking, this is mountain, so any association. You're an art class, but childhood, so you go back to your childhood. All association, different kind of association, different people have. Swimming. A wonderful word here, which I think is needed and at this juncture of life or this era right now, post-COVID. Stress. Why is stress created now? Where does this come in? If you see here, the entire critical mind is full. It gets congested with your thoughts because your thoughts may be 15,000 message units per minute, may have gone beyond that because you can't process it at some point in time. You can't. It's impossible. I normally don't like to use that word, but it is impossible. It can be possible by changing something, right? Now, what needs to be changed? Clearing the critical mind filter. Clearing it. Simple. We make, let's say we are making a cup of tea, right? What we do is we have to strain the chai ki patti. What do? We use a strainer and we pour it. All of the chai ki patti is there in the strainer. What we do with that? We don't put it back in the cup. We throw it. That chai ki patti in that strainer is the critical mind filter, which is all clogged up. We need to clear it. After that, after some time, you also see that that mesh that is there on the strainer also carries that the tannin, which is the tea ingredient, and it creates that blackness. Right? Then you use a brush. Purana wala hamara toothbrush reh gaya hai. That's a typical way. And we brush it. And we make it shine. Right? That's exactly the process which happens. Because if you don't do that, if you don't clear your critical mind filter, later on whatever data is being received from your environment, from your body, from your conscious and your subconscious mind, all of that gets clogged up. Drainage ka pipe clog up ho gaya hai, upar se pani ja raha hai, niche se pani outlet se nahi ja raha hai, all the water is coming up in the basin. Another example. That is how it happens, and mind is not like a robot. It operates out of thought. It operates out of something different, and you have the power to change that one thought which needs to go into all of this so that you don't experience stress. And if you do, these are the ways. A complete 8-hour sleep. Meditation. Generally for more than 15 to 20 minutes. Not 5 minutes ke meditation se clear nahi hoga. Okay. The third part is hypnosis. So using hypnosis. So I do hypnotherapy. So using hypnosis, there is therapy work. There is also something which is called as guided meditation, which also releases you of that. And there is breath work. That is again a completely different way of doing it. So concentrating on your breathing. That in itself takes you into a trance. So breathing is also equivalent to a hypnosis state. So all of this, what is all of this doing? Shutting off everything from the outside world. Look at it. Pure common sense. All the data is coming in from the environment into the conscious mind. But you shut off the entire world around you. The smaller world, of course. But anything that you want to listen to or look at, you close your eyes. You maybe plug in something, some earbuds, you have some guided meditation or some music. Why are you doing that? Because you want to go deeper inside yourself. You don't want to listen to anything outside. You don't want to see anything outside. Two senses closed, ready to go inside. And then start feeling what is happening inside. And then when you are aware that you are feeling stressed, you are feeling uneasy, you are doing whatever, do whatever needs to be done. Like a wise man, like a wise woman. So, stress is sometimes inevitable. You do get stressed. There is physical stress, there is emotional stress. Physical stress, you need physical rest. Please understand. And emotional rest, you need the venting out. You need to talk about it. You need to say it out. That saying it out also helps. Because as a counselor, I know so many people come to me only to talk and vent out. Because they don't have anyone who listens to them. So that venting out. So let it go. Let it go out of your system. Right? Because we know that if we are physically tired, but our mind is very strong and you want to go for a movie with your friends, wouldn't you get up and, you know, put on t-shirt, jacket, jeans and out of the house? You're physically tired. But movie ke liye jaake seat mein hi to baithna hai, popcorn aur coffee peeni hai, ya coke peena hai. That's it. Wonderful. But physically you are not as tired, but mentally you are completely down. Mentally you are all so, your energy has been so sucked up that you can't do anything. So physically you have not done any efforts, but mental stress, mental tension is so much that your body does not move. That's the power of your mind. That body will not move. Because your mind is not giving the right instructions to the brain to move. Like at the start I was telling you, I want to go and to sit on the chair. I will move. This is the indication. This is the signal. The mind gives the brain and the brain gives it to the body. So when I started, I am coming to an end. But this is how your mind is so powerful. So I am really making it as simple as possible. I'm trying to explain these because I think post-COVID people really need to understand where does the fear come in from and how can they deal with it. How do you get stress and what is depression all about? Yeah. So thank you so much for being such amazing audience and giving me all the replies and asking me questions as well. I will try to cover as many questions as possible in my series of Soul Talk with Shruti. But please do not forget to share and subscribe also, because I want this to spread. The awareness needs to be spread and people need to understand how they can overcome their stress and how they can get out of depression. So thank you so much. Be connected. God bless from Solace the Healing Studio. I'm Shruti Sudhwekar bidding you goodbye for this episode. Thank you.